welcome to St. James Youth Online. My name is Welsh and I'm one of the youth workers here at St. James. I hope that you guys are well. Now, as you know, we are still looking at different passages in the Bible just to encourage each other through this time of lockdown. A few weeks ago, we looked at a passage in Isaiah chapter 40 where Isaiah was telling us that those whose hope is in the Lord, he will renew their strength. That God will exchange our worn-out strength for his strength, for new strength, fresh strength, and that we need to keep trusting him during this time. And last week, Jeremy was helping us to think about prayer. And that's what we're going to do again this week. Jeremy is going to be taking us through Philippians chapter 4, verse 4-9. Now, I want you to quickly grab your Bible, pause this if you need to, and I'm going to read it for us. But before I do that, let me pray for us. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you, Lord, that your word has the power to transform any life. We pray, Lord, that you will help Jeremy as he speaks to us, that he would be faithful to your word. We pray, Lord, that you will help us as well to be not just to be hearers of your word, but to be doers of your word, that you will help us to respond to your word in a manner that is appropriate. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent and praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learnt or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and God of peace will be with you.
Hi guys, nice to be with you again. Hope you had a good week. Did you enjoy some of the sunshine? Did you see last week's youth video? And do you remember what we were talking about then? There was that verse that we looked at where Luke 5:16, it said that Jesus often withdrew to lonely places and prayed. And there's that challenge to what degree we leave things in order to spend time with God in prayer and reading our Bibles. Do you remember? So I wonder, this past week, have you paused at all? Have you taken time just to step back from other things and to spend time with your Bible, spend time in prayer? That's the challenge, isn't it? Well, half term is here. I expect many of you have been looking forward to that. And half term gives an opportunity to leave some things and to spend time differently, doesn't it? I'm sure some of you just can't wait to leave the online lessons, to leave the assignments, to leave all that schoolwork, I suppose. Although I know some of you are probably sitting there thinking, they've given us extra work, or they've given us this to do or that to do. I don't know, perhaps for some, it's not quite the break that others are going to enjoy. But anyway, you understand the principle of time away from some things. And so it's that discipline, isn't it, of, for all of us, stepping aside. So half term gives you an opportunity to spend time a bit differently. And so you could be building into your days time for reading your Bible and prayer. Although we don't have to wait for half term. No, actually, I mean, every day gives us that opportunity to be doing just that, doesn't it? Now, the passage we're looking at today has these verses. This is Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. That's Philippians 4, 6 and 7. And it says, don't be anxious, don't worry about anything. It says, do not be anxious about anything. Well, that covers most things, doesn't it? So we don't need to worry about when school might restart and all that kind of thing. We don't need to worry about the exams you're not taking, because some of you are not doing GCSEs and A-levels. Well, we're told here we don't need to worry about those things. Those holiday plans for the summer, don't need to worry. Relationships, don't need to worry. Don't need to worry about what other people think of us. All those plans for the future, we don't need to worry. University places, for example, that seem a little bit up in the air, we don't need to worry. That's what we're being told. Do not be anxious about anything. So, don't worry, but in every situation, we're told, present your requests to God. So that's it. Don't worry, present your requests to God. And that's the habit that we need to develop. That's the discipline. And it's a little bit like the verse we looked at last week. Do you remember 1 Peter 5:7? Leave all your worries with him because he cares for you. Now, these are habits we need to develop. God cares, so we don't need to worry. We can leave our worries, we can leave our anxieties with him in prayer. And, you know, I think it is wonderful that we can pour our hearts out before God in a way that perhaps we never do with other people. We can be absolutely honest. We can tell God our desires. We can express our emotions. We can tell him the confusion, the questions, all the frustration, the anger, the disappointments, the hopes, the dreams we have. Whatever it is, we can pour it out. And we can just put it there before God and say, this is it. This is how I feel. This is what my situation is. This is the way it's going. We can pour it all out. And that is wonderful. It really is a great privilege that we have. Whatever it is, everything, we can bring it before God in prayer. And the point is, it won't surprise him. It won't, because he already knows. He already knows. So I can't surprise him or shock him. I can pour it all out and know that he knows. So we're to present our requests to God. So what actually are my requests? What do I want to be asking for? Well, I sometimes realize that actually I don't know what's best. I don't really know the way through particular situations. I know how I perhaps feel about it, or I might know what I want, or at least I think I know what I want. But I realize that, you know, I see life from such a limited perspective. And there's the whole world out there, and I don't see it all, and I don't see fully how my life fits into the big picture. But God does see. He knows my life in its entirety, and he sees the world, and he does know how I fit in, and he does know what's best for me. And so when I see that, I can begin to realize that actually it is best when I come before God and I pour my heart out and I say, and Father, through all this, your will be done. Your will be done. And, you know, that's what we saw Jesus doing at the end of his life, just before he was arrested, when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane. Knowing what was coming, he was before his Father in prayer, and he was saying, Father, if it's possible, take this cup, take this suffering from me. But he went on to say, but not my will, but yours be done. And I think it's so encouraging. We see Jesus doing that, and we can do the same. We can come and pour our hearts out, and we can be ourselves, and then we can say, Father, your will be done through all this. Perhaps sometimes I simply need to ask, Father, help me not to worry. Help me to trust you. Or simply, Father, help me. Help me. And I have to leave things with God, don't I? I have to leave my concerns, because I need to stop worrying about them and chewing over them. I need to to bring them before God in prayer, and then to leave them with him. And that becomes an act of trust, doesn't it? God is able to sort it out. He does want my best. He is for me. He is reliable and dependable and faithful. And sometimes I just have to tell myself these things. I can leave whatever it is with him and trust him. Because of who he is, because of his character, that's why I can trust him. Who he is means he's trustworthy. Verse 6, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything with prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. But in everything, every situation, this should be the way we live. So all the time, I should be coming before God prayerfully. Whatever it is, I should be turning to God in prayer. That doesn't mean that I'm always dropping to my knees or taking up a particular posture. No, it just means that really wherever I am, whoever I'm with, whatever I'm doing, I can from inside, I can present something to God. I can talk it over with God. I can express it in my mind to God. I can give him my attention and say, Father, there's this. This is what I'm facing. This is the issue. So every situation, with thanksgiving. Do you remember last week there was that verse, 1 Thessalonians 5:18, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. It's developing that thankfulness, isn't it? It's just learning to be thankful. Or we could say developing an attitude of gratitude. Okay, you might find that's all a bit cheesy, or you might find it helpful, but I'll leave it with you. Thankfulness keeps us kind of rightly focused before God, and it's a good foundation when we're bringing other things before him as well. So we need to learn to be thankful and to express that thankfulness as well. And then we go on to verse 7, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. The peace of God. God will give us his peace. It's like an inner quiet confidence that it's all right. Because I'm not looking at my circumstances. They may be confusing. The circumstances might be scary. They might feel like they're too much for me. But I'm not looking at those. No, I'm choosing to look to God. I'm choosing to remember that he's good, that he's got this. I'm choosing to record and to tell myself that he understands and he cares, that he's faithful and he can be trusted. The peace that God gives is beyond understanding. It transcends understanding because it doesn't seem to make sense. You see, the circumstances would suggest that I shouldn't be peaceful, but rather the world would expect us to worry, to freak out, to despair. That's what sometimes the world might expect of us. But actually, we can know the peace of God because we don't look at the circumstances. We look to God. We choose to look to him beyond the circumstances. And I trust him because of who he is, his character. How do I increasingly have confidence in God and his character and his ways? Well, I need to read about him in the Bible. So I need to just keep reading the Bible. I need to be familiar with God and his ways. And I need to keep talking with him. And so as I read and as I talk and pray, so I slowly gain confidence in God and who he is and the way he is and his perspective on life. And his having that foundation in life is the best foundation. It's the only foundation we can really rely on, living our lives with God, knowing him and trusting him. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Come with me to the prayer wall in the St. James Centre. So here we are at the prayer wall. Now, we were talking about having confidence in God and his character and his ways. And how do we do that? Well, we become increasingly familiar with his word and through speaking and talking with him in prayer. And those two go hand in hand. And I want to help you with that. Now, you could be following the daily devotionals, which are available every day from St. James, Monday to Saturday. They're excellent. So do plug into those and benefit from them. But alternatively, this coming week, half term, I want to suggest you could, for example, on Monday, you could read Psalm 139. It's a psalm that just tells us how much God knows us and the details of our lives. And it gives us such reassurance and comfort that God, he knows me, he knows you fully, completely. So why not on Monday read Psalm 139 and think about what it's saying? And then having read it, you could just start to talk to God about the different things that come out. Because it's marvellous, some of the things that are said about the way that God knows us. So that's Monday. Tuesday, Isaiah 40. Why don't you read Isaiah chapter 40 on Tuesday? And I'll say read the whole chapter, but verses 25 to 28. Let me just read a couple of bits. To whom will you compare me? Or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift your eyes and look to the heavens. Who created all these? He who brings out the starry host one by one and calls them each by name. Because of his great power and mighty strength, not one of them is missing. So it's describing God as the creator, the one who has the universe under control. So why not on Tuesday read Isaiah chapter 40 and reflect on that and think, wow, that is incredible. God is the one with all power and authority. And he knows the details of my life, so I can trust him. Wednesday, Psalm 145. Read the whole psalm. But verses 8 and 9, they talk about God being good and compassionate and loving and kind. And when we just pause and absorb that, why wouldn't we trust God? Why wouldn't we keep coming before him in prayer and just asking him to lead us through things? So that was up to Wednesday, wasn't it? Thursday, Romans chapter 8, and particularly verses 31 to 39. God is for you. And it says that. It says that God is for us. So we have to remember, sometimes we can get all sorts of twisted ideas and we think that he's not for us. But the truth is, he is for you. He's in favor of you. And he wants your best. That's so comforting and reassuring. Friday, why not read Psalm 23? You might think that you know it. It's the one about the Lord's my shepherd. But just read it, perhaps read it two or three times. And just reflect and absorb the truths there. God is our shepherd, leading us the best way, taking care of us, overseeing our lives, providing for us along the way. Wonderful. So why not do that on Friday? And Saturday, it's back to Romans, but it's Romans 8, 28. And it's a verse, let me just read it to you. It says about God wanting to work all things together for our ultimate good. And it is so important that we hang on to that. Romans 8, 28. And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. There we are. God wants to work things for our ultimate good. Remember, he's for us. He's for you. So, there we go. This week, I don't know whether you want to take a picture of the screen. I know I'm standing in the way, aren't I? Or quickly jot them down, or you'll have to watch this video all over again. But why not do that this week and grow in confidence, knowing that God knows you, he's all-powerful, he's the creator, but he's good and loving and kind and compassionate. He's for you. He wants to lead us and provide for us. He wants to work all things together for our ultimate good. Isn't that a good enough reason? So the more we read, the Bible and get the truths of who God is and his character, we can trust him. We can trust him with the big things in life, with the small things, with the everyday things, with the things that come up just after you've watched this video. Okay? Well, let me just read our verses for today one more time. Philippians 4, 6 and 7. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, would you increasingly move us to prayer, that we would be prayerful people, we would live our lives prayerfully, in touch with you. Father, help us not to worry. We need to learn not to worry, but to trust you. Would you help us with that? Would you help us to be those who live with thankful hearts, who recall what you do for us and the way that you are, and we are thankful. And therefore, we come before you from that perspective of being thankful people. Father, may we instinctively be those who desire your will through our lives, our situations, circumstances, but we desire it. May we increasingly be those people with that desire in our hearts to see your will lived out. Father, the week ahead is half term. Thank you that we can trust you. And so we ask that you would lead us through this coming week. Would you help us to make time for you with prayer and Bible reading, and to increasingly have the truths of Scripture in our hearts, moulding us and shaping us. Keep us all looking to you, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Great. Thank you so much, Jeremy, for sharing God's word with us. That was really helpful. So next week, all our St. James Youth Online activities will be on pause as it is half term. But I'm really looking forward to seeing you guys the following week. Have a great half term.